How much is the time now to be making automated ships suddenly far more prevalent when we've got US-China tensions?
The time is definitely now. If we hear the current administration, they're talking about shipbuilding, shipbuilding, and shipbuilding. And we're designing and building autonomous ships. And when you make them autonomous, you can remove the bridge, the berthing, the galley, the showers. So you can make them a lot smaller. And because they're smaller, you don't have to build them at the big Navy shipyards. So we should continue to build the big warships, the guided missile destroyers, the aircraft carriers, the submarines, as quickly as possible. But our ship can be built at all these mid-tier shipyards that have capacity today.
Why is now the right time from a technology perspective as well? What is going into making automation far more easy, or certainly not easy, but far more able to enact right now?
Yeah, well, this is a hard problem. This is not easy because we're designing ships that can operate across the open ocean. And the last thing our Navy needs is for these ships to be dead in the water in the middle of the ocean. Mm. And the ocean is extreme. You're thinking about extreme temperatures and salt water. In fact, ships get hit by lightning. And so we need to build a very... It happens. As we did research for this, and we talked to the chief engineers on some of the sort of work boats that operate around the United States, they said, yeah, last week my ship got hit by lightning and it fried all the electronics. And so... there's a ton of challenges to do this, but we feel we have the team to do this because we've been at some of the most successful robotic companies in the United States, and two of my co-founders, including myself, we were also in the Navy.
Rylan, the big picture is to modernize the maritime industry, but this is a Navy application, as you just point out. American dynamism, this big emphasis on the private sector's relationship with the military-industrial complex. What is it that you actually want the president to do to allow for you to make this a success?
So we want to move fast, and we'll move as fast as the Navy wants us to move. And so we definitely want the president to continue to focus on shipbuilding and innovation, especially around autonomous systems. And there are autonomous systems that are in the air, that are on the surface, and that are underwater. Our focus is on these autonomous ships that can operate on the surface of the water and have high endurance and range, the range that you need for the Pacific Ocean.
Anduril picked Ohio for its skilled labor and for its history in aviation, for example. Yeah. Where is your Ohio? Where do you think you need to build these ships?
So we'll have more to announce later this year, but we've definitely been looking for the perfect place to go build these ships. And there are a lot of really good options, whether it's on the East Coast or the West Coast or sort of in the Gulf. And so we'll make an announcement later this year.
You were early leader in Amazon Robotics when you were building Six River Systems. How good is U.S. at manufacturing now? Can we bring back what we want to bring back?
Yeah. So the U.S. is actually really good at advanced manufacturing. So early in my career, I was at Amazon Robotics when there were a couple thousand robots in the field. There are now over 1 million robots in Amazon warehouses throughout the world. That is amazing what that company has done over the last 10 years. So when it comes to complex systems where you need to take sort of commercial off-the-shelf components and put them together and then write the software on top, we're amazing at that.